My name is John Jameson. I am a professor of marine geology at Memorial University in St. John's, Newfoundland, Canada. My role aboard Expedition 376 is I'm part of a team of core describers who are interested in the alteration of the rocks that we are collecting from below the volcano. These rocks are being altered by hydrothermal fluids, which is one of the things I spend a lot of my time studying. So hydrothermal systems form under the seafloor whenever you have hot water from shallow volcanic activity. These systems host very unique ecosystems which rely on chemical energy as opposed to the sun. These hot fluids transport metals that are very interesting to society. And one of the neat things about Brothers Volcano is that we see two very different styles of fluid coming out at the seafloor, driven by the heat of the volcano. So most of the research cruises that I participate on, we use remotely operated vehicles or submersibles sometimes, and autonomous underwater vehicles. We're mapping the ocean floor. We are sampling from the ocean floor. That only gives us a two-dimensional picture of the system. But one of the really unique aspects of this cruise in particular, the fact that we are drilling beneath the seafloor, it gives us that very critical third dimension so that we understand what's happening below the seafloor. So expectations are always a dangerous thing in science. I think we all had expectations of what we would see in the core that we've recovered from Brothers Volcano. And there have been many, many surprises. The types of minerals and the types of textures that we're seeing that we simply didn't expect to find. But that, we like that. We like that surprises. It means there's a lot of stories to tell. There's a lot of things to learn. So I actually got to go down to the bottom of the ocean and see a black smoker chimney up close with my own eyes, which was, of course, just an absolutely amazing, unique experience. I vividly remember looking out the tiny porthole and seeing the seafloor emerge out of, you know, just the blue nothingness of the ocean. And so, of course, your first feeling is, oh my gosh, I'm at the bottom of the ocean. But then when we drive around, we get to the black smokers, and there's all the lava features on the seafloor, and there's cracks and fissures, and I mean, it's a mountain range down there, and the colors are so vivid. You know, we just see a flat surface on the ocean surface, and there's a whole other world down there with mountains and plains and valleys, and I just can't wait to go back. So I spent a year of my life at sea, and I hope that number just keeps growing. It's a lot of work. They're long days. We've been out here almost 2 months now. After this cruise, I head home for, I think, 2 days, and then I'm back out onto another ship in the Northern Hemisphere for a change. And I'm already looking forward to that. So I love being out at sea. I really like it out here.